Hello and welcome to the course Design and Analysis of Algorithms. In today's lecture, we will discuss knapsack problem and its solution using dynamic programming. So what is a knapsack problem? We are given a set of n items with each item I having a positive weight wi and a positive benefit bi. Our goal is to choose items with maximum total benefit but with a weight at most w, which is the capacity of the knapsack. If fractional amounts are not allowed, then this is the 0-1 knapsack problem. In this case, we let T denote the sum of items we take. So our objective is to maximize the sum of all the benefits of the items we have selected, subject to the constraint that the total weight of those items should be less than or equal to the capacity of the knapsack. Given the following four items with specific weights and benefit and a knapsack capacity of 16. If we use the brute force approach, we will find out all the possible combination of subsets or sets we can make from these four items, find out their total weight and the total value. So we go through all combinations and find the one with the maximum value and with total weight less than or equal to the capacity of the sack. In this case, the non-feasible combinations are ignored since the weight has exceeded the capacity of the sack. For the remaining subsets, we look at the total value, which is the maximum. So in this case, for this particular problem, item 2 and item 3 give us the maximum total benefit of 80. The total complexity of this approach is 2 to the power of n, since we have to find all the possible combination of these four items, or n items in the case of n is equal to very large number. The general dynamic programming technique applies to problems that at first seem to require a lot of time, possible exponential, provided we have simple subproblems. The subproblems can be defined in terms of a few variables: subproblem optimality. The global optimum value can be defined in terms of optimal subproblems, and subproblem overlap. The subproblems are not independent, but instead they overlap and hence should be constructed bottom up. Let's try to design a solution of knapsack problem using dynamic programming. We are given a set of items numbered 1 to k. We define b, k to be the best selection from the set, which gives us the maximum benefit for the subproblem of size k. So b1 will be the smallest subproblem containing only first item, and B2 will be the subproblem containing the first two item, and so on. But this selection of item based on item numbers to define a subproblem does not lead to subproblem optimality. The solution to the larger subproblem might not contain optimal solution for the smaller problem. Consider, for example, the following example of 5 items with their given weights and benefits and the knapsack capacity of 20. So our smallest subproblem will be to select item number 1. Then the larger subproblem will be selecting item 2 with item number 1. And the larger subproblem will be selecting item number 3 along with item number 1 and 2. And the larger subproblem will be selecting item number 4 along with the first three items. Since the remaining sack capacity is 6, the last item cannot be inserted. So this is the best solution with first four items. Now consider another scenario where we select the first three items, and instead of selecting the fourth item, we select the larger item, which is giving us more benefit, We achieve a maximum benefit of 26. And this is the best solution for the first 5 items. But the solution for S4 is not part of the solution for S5. So our definition of subproblem is flawed and we need another one. Considering only item number in the subproblem is not sufficient. Let's add another parameter W, which will represent the maximum weight for each subset of items. The subproblem then will be to compute B of KW, that is to find the best selection from SK in a knapsack of size W. Assuming we know B, I and J, where I is a subset of items from 1 to k minus 1, then we can derive the value of B of KW, which is a subproblem containing k items. The goal is to find B of n capital W, where n is the total number of items and capital W is the knapsack capacity. Good news is that our definition of subproblem does have subproblem optimality. We have two cases here, that is, the best subset of SK with weight at most W is either the best subset of SK minus 1 with weight at most W, which means that we have already obtained the optimal solution without item K, or the best subset of SK minus 1 with weight at most W minus WK plus the item K. From the two cases, we choose the one which gives us the greater value. If the weight of the item is greater than the subproblem weight capacity, we just take the maximum benefit of the smaller subproblem K minus 1. To compute the optimal solution, we use the bottom-up approach to first find the optimal solution to subproblems and then use them to find the optimal solution to the problem. Since we are using two parameters, the number of items and the weight, to define the subproblem, we will use a two-dimensional table as follows. We will start filling the table from top left to bottom right. A cell in a table represents a single subproblem. For example, this cell here represents a subproblem that has 2 items and the sack capacity of 1. Similarly, this cell over here defines the sack weight of capital W and total number of items is equal to n. So this is actually the whole problem solution, while these cells here are solution to the subproblems. Following is the pseudocode for knapsack problem using dynamic programming. Initially, the first row and first column of the table are assigned all zeros, since the subproblem with 0 item will always give you 0 benefit, and subproblem with a weight capacity of 0 will always give you 0 benefit. Then for all subproblems from 1 to n and all subweights from 0 to w, we compute the following. If the weight of the item is less than the subweight capacity of the capacity of the weight, then item I can be part of the solution. So in this part here, item I is part of the solution, and in this part here, item I is not part of the solution, since we are getting more benefit without item K or I. If the weight of the item I exceeds the capacity, we will use the benefit that we achieved from the smaller subproblem. Let's run our algorithm on the following example. We have 4 items, the sack capacity of 5, item weights and benefits are given. To solve this problem, we will fill out the following table. We will have an extra column and an extra row for the zero item and zero weight, since we are assuming our subproblem to be of zero weight and zero item as well. We will initialize the first row and the first columns with zeros, as we are not receiving any benefits from zero item and zero weight. The second row in the table represents subproblem with only one item. So the first iteration, I is equal to 1. The benefit of item 1 is 3. The weight of item 1 is 2. The weight of the subproblem, or the maximum weight of the subproblem, is 1. And since the weight of the item exceeds the weight of the subproblem, we will just copy the maximum benefit achieved from a smaller subproblem. For subproblem with item 1 and capacity 2, we see that the weight of the item does not exceed the weight of the sack. Now we will see, do we get more benefit by putting K in the sack, or we get more benefit without it? Without K, we will get zero benefit from the smaller subproblem. With item K, we will get a benefit of 3. Since the item has a weight of 2, and to place it into the sack, there need to be at least a space of 2 available so that this item can be inserted into the sack. So we go 2 places back and 1 up for the smaller subproblem here, so that we can add this item into the sack. So the benefit for adding K into the sack will be 0 plus 3. So we have 3 here. Similarly, for the next problem with weight 3, we need to compare the benefit of with and without K. So without K, our benefit is 0. With K, our benefit is 3 plus the benefit we will get from the subproblem of weight 1, which is the previous problem. So 0 plus 3 is again 3. Similarly, with subproblem of weight 4 and subproblem with weight 5 will be 3. Row 3 in the table represents subproblem that can contain item 1 and 2. For the second iteration, for second item, the benefit will be 4, weight is 3, the capacity of the sack in the first cell, second cell here, is 1, and the difference of the weight is minus 2, which means that the weight of the item is more than the sack capacity of this subproblem. So we will just copy the benefit that we achieved from the previous subproblem. Similarly, since item 2 has a weight of 3 and we are solving a subproblem with a weight of 2, the item weight exceeds the capacity, and we will just copy the benefit from the previous subproblem. For the subproblem of weight capacity 3, if we don't select item 2, we get a benefit of 3 from the previous subproblem. If we select item 2, we have to go back to this location in the previous subproblem. Here, the benefit was 0 plus the benefit of adding this item 2 is 4. So the total benefit we are achieving by putting item 2 is 4, and without putting item 2 we have a benefit of 3. So 4 is greater than 3, so we will insert 4 in the table. Similarly, for sub problem with weight 4, we will see that without item 2 our benefit is 3, and with item 2 our benefit is 0 plus 4, so we write down 4 here in the table. For sub problem of weight 5, if we do not select second item, our benefit will be 3. If we select item 2, we will have to go to this location in the previous subproblem. The benefit of that subproblem was 3 plus the benefit of adding item 2 is 4. So we are achieving a total benefit of 7. So we write down 7 in this table. The fourth row in the table represents the subproblem that can contain item 1, 2 and 3. Since the weight of the item 3 is 4, so for subproblem with weight 1, 2 and 3, item 3 cannot be placed in the sack, so we will just copy the benefit we are achieving from the previous subproblems. For the subproblem with weight capacity 4, without item 3, we are achieving a benefit of 4. If we include item 3, then we will get a benefit of 0 plus the benefit of item 3, which is 5. 5 is greater than 4, so we place 5 in the table. For the subproblem with weight capacity 5, without item 3, we are achieving a benefit of 7, and with item 3, we will go and look into the index 1 of the previous problem, which is 0. 0 plus the benefit of item 3 is 5. So we are achieving more benefit without putting item 3 into the knapsack. So we just copy the benefit of the previous subproblem into this location in the table. The last row here represents the subproblem that can contain all the 4 items. Since the weight of the item 4 is 5, so for subproblem with weight 1, 2, 3 and 4, this item cannot be placed into the sack. So we will just copy the benefits we are achieving from the previous subproblems. For the problem with weight capacity 5 and all 4 items, we are getting a benefit of 7 without item 4. What will be the benefit with item 4? So we will go to the location 0 of the previous subproblem. Here the benefit is 0 plus the benefit of item 4, which is 6. Since 7 is greater than 6, hence 4 is ignored, and we copy the previous benefit into the table and we are done. Since the last cell of the table represents the result or the solution to the actual problem, the maximum possible value that can be carried in this knapsack is $7. This algorithm only finds the maximum possible value that can be carried into the knapsack. To know the items that make this maximum value, we need to trace back through this table. So we will modify a code a little bit. By backtracking, how would we know which item is included in the knapsack We compare the value with the previous subproblem. If they are same, it means that this item here did not contribute to the knapsack. That is why we copied this value here. So item 4 is not in the knapsack. And we move on. With item 4 out of the question, our next subproblem will be the first three items. So we compare the last two values here. They are the same, which means that item 3 did not contribute, and we copied this value here. So item 3 does not belong to the knapsack. So we move on. With item 3 out of the equation, we are left with subproblem with the first two items. We compare these two values. They are not same, which means that item 2 has contributed into the knapsack. So we place item 2 in the knapsack. The weight of item 2 is 3, which means that out of the capacity of 5, the knapsack contains a weight of 3. So we are left with a weight of 2 only, which is free in the knapsack. So we move on to a subproblem which has weight capacity of 2. And since we have already selected item 2, our next subproblem or smaller subproblem will be with item 1 and weight 2. We compare these two values. They are different. So that means item 1 has contributed to the knapsack. So we place item 1 in the knapsack. The weight of item 2 or weight of item 1 was 2. So we move 2 step back and 1 step up. Since we have reached 0, we have found the items that were in the knapsack. So we are done. The optimal knapsack should contain item 1 and 2 with a maximum benefit of 7. What is the complexity of this algorithm? The first two for loops will be of order of W and order of N. Then we have a nested loop with outer loop of N and inner loop of W. So our total complexity will be NW. Remember that the brute force algorithm took 2 to the power of N complexity, and we have reduced it down to NW. For your practice, please try out the following two problems. So what's the difference between greedy algorithms versus dynamic programming? Greedy algorithms and dynamic programming are similar. Both generally work under the same circumstances. Both techniques rely on the presence of optimal substructure. The optimal solution contains the optimal solution to subproblems. Dynamic programming solves subproblems first, then makes a decision. Greedy algorithms make decisions first and then solve subproblems, which is greedy choice property gains efficiency. Consider the 01 knapsack problem. Greedy algorithm will pick as much of the most valuable item first, which does not necessarily give optimal value. So for a 01 knapsack problem, greedy algorithm will not be suitable. I hope you have enjoyed the lecture on 01 knapsack problem. Thank you and have a nice day.